Tonle Sap Lake is a natural body of water in Cambodia, near the capital city of Phnom Penh, and within a short distance from the famous ruins of the Angkor Wat temple complex. It is the largest freshwater lake in Southeast Asia and is renowned for its ecological significance and cultural importance to the region. During the dry season, the lake covers around 2,700 square kilometers, but expands during the wet season to over 16,000 square kilometers when the Mekong River swells due to monsoon rains. The lake and its surrounding floodplain support a rich biodiversity, including many rare and endangered species of fish, birds, and mammals. It is also a crucial habitat for various migratory birds, making it a designated Ramsar site, a wetland of international importance. Fishing is a primary economic activity for many communities around the Tonle Sap Lake. The lake supports a diverse range of fish species, including several commercially valuable ones. Competition is fierce, and while commercial operations vary in scale, they dwarf subsistence fishing practiced by locals. In recent years, overfishing and unsustainable fishing practices have led to concerns about the depletion of fish stocks in the lake. Illegal fishing activities further exacerbate these issues. Tonle Sap's proximity to the capital and Angkor Wat makes it a prime destination for tourists who want to see the unique lifestyle of the floating villages. There is a certain timeless wonder to witnessing entire communities of houses built on stilts along the lake's shoreline. Visitors often take boat tours to explore the villages, observe traditional fishing techniques, and experience the daily life of the residents. However, unregulated tourism can pose challenges, such as environmental degradation, cultural disruption, and exploitation of local resources. All of these activities take a toll on the locals. The lake is surrounded by more than a few impoverished communities, including children who face significant challenges in terms of access to education, healthcare, and basic necessities. Life in these villages can be quite tough, with families often relying on fishing and subsistence agriculture for their livelihoods, while only a few benefit from tourism revenue. Most residents live on subsistence fishing and growing local fruits and vegetables, or from meager incomes derived from selling trinkets to tourists. Their children often walk barefoot on dusty, unpaved roads, or navigate the lake in small canoes to go to school or to neighboring communities. As with most impoverished communities, recreation takes a back seat to repairing fishing nets of patching thatched roofs. The concept of play seems to be as foreign to these children as their lifestyle is to curious tourists. Several NGOs and charitable organizations work in these areas to provide support to children and families. They often focus on initiatives such as providing access to education, healthcare services, clean water, and nutritional support. And while such assistance may help in the short term, the sustainability of the villages at Tonle Sap Lake seems bleak, and the prospects for the children's futures are very limited. Indeed, where do the children play? And perhaps more importantly, where do they go from here?
Oh, we've come a long way. We're changing day to day.
But tell me, where do the children play?